All right, good Thursday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen. Onek. Things are, again, decently quiet. Got a lot of sunshine out there. That's something we haven't seen for a while, so we are looking at some decently quiet conditions in that location for the Mid-South area and points beyond. Doesn't look like too much to worry about in the near future, but we may see, again, the potential of some problems heading our way as we get into the course of the rest of the week and into the week. Weekend. Again, so far, not really much of a major problem, but if you do have any plans for New Year's Eve, you definitely want to stick around and keep it tuned to News Channel 3 because we'll keep you updated on the potential for maybe some snow showers and maybe even more than that as we get into the early part of 2018. Very chilly today, very much on the cold side as we go back to work or school as we head into and around areas close to New Year's. Again, starting things off very much on the cold side out there for right now. So not really seeing too much of any good news out there where it comes to the amount of precipitation. Missy Wilson 70, thank you very much for joining us on News Channel 3 for our live weather segment at this time. And now welcoming in, I hope everybody is able to see and hear me. Let's see, the microphone looks like it's doing pretty well. Let me bring this out here. Hopefully should be able to hear things pretty good at this point. We're doing things a little differently this morning. We are back in the weather office again, as per usual, doing some end-of-the-year taping segments with a couple of our guests out in the studio at this point. So forgive the hurried setup in here for the rest of the day today. Hopefully you can see the computer graphics on Weather One. This is going to be, again, something the... We'll be telling you more about the weather situation here in just a little bit. Michael Clark on Facebook, how did I take the Doctor Who Christmas special? Actually, I haven't. I don't have cable at home. I'm not really a fan of paying for 92 different sports channels, and I have not had a chance to see it just yet on the internet. So no spoilers, if you don't mind, but I'm sure I'll get to it here in the next couple of days. Working the schedule, a little bit difficult to get into anything recreational, but we'll get there eventually, I'm pretty sure. Apologies for the wibble-wobble on the camera there. Hopefully we'll get that taken care of here in just a little bit. Got questions? @_less. Thanks for joining us, or @Oles, I guess I could say, on Periscope and Twitter. Thank you very much for joining us on there. Let's go ahead and get started. If I can find my keyboard and mouse around here for just a little bit. Currently in the Mid-South, these are what the wind chills are looking like, and it is not comfortable out there to say the least. We've got temperatures easily back into the single digits around Dyersburg at the airport, teens across much of the rest of the Mid-South, so we are seeing again some very chilly conditions into and around the area. Grady Bennett, what was that flash by there? 21 in Berclair and sunny. Thank you very much for that, but if you are going to be outdoors for today, this is what you're going to have to deal with. So again, not a morning to throw on a jacket and a cap. Make certain you've got, again, layers on, scarf, hat. Substantial hat would be a good idea, stocking cap or better, a watch cap on a day like this. And don't forget something for the gloves, because these can get very cold very quickly, especially if you get a flat tire someplace. Hope I don't jinx anything, but again, something to think about if you're going to be outdoors for any period of time with numbers like this around for the rest of the day here for today. Yeah, earthquakes when it comes to areas of the Mid-South. Gone CVR, thank you very much for joining us on Periscope and Twitter for this morning via the United States Geological Survey or the Center for Earthquake Research and Information from the University of Memphis. All you have to do is stop by there for some great weather great earthquake information. This is not weather details, granted, per se, but we like to keep track of this stuff because we live very close up here to the New Madrid fault line, so it's something we like to keep in mind here at News Channel 3 and be ready for stuff that may happen right there. By the way, if you've never tuned into this before, thanks for joining us. And again, here's the weather information for the Mid-South in the blue bar here. Social media information here. Also above the website, floating above my head at WREG.com/weather. And thanks a lot to everybody for joining me. City Hall in Germantown. Beautiful blue skies with a few clouds out off onto the distance there. And view from Poplar Pike in Germantown showing 24 degrees, winds east at 8, and humidity fairly low. So a very dry day and a wind chill of about 15 degrees. Michael Clark, yeah, hoping to catch the regeneration scene at some point in time. I'll get there, I promise. I just haven't really done it just yet. The cold snap going to become bearable? Well, yes and no. We've got, again, the sort of moderation of temperatures coming up, but unfortunately, it's not going to be sticking around for long. Let's just say that. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. Cold and dry downtown. The reflection wading pool area at the Delta of the Mississippi on Mud Island emptied out and very quiet and dry into that area. Stacy D. Dowdy, welcome from Selmer, Tennessee for this morning. And thanks to everybody who's checking in on Facebook, Periscope, and Twitter for today. From the area around our transmitter tower cam at I-40 and Witten Road, looking at the area into around I-40 and Sycamore View. And of course, the flyover traffic is moving along pretty well. Some pretty heavy traffic early this morning and the occasional area of backups taking place. But so far, it looks like things are doing decently well for travelers out there. Likewise, at Memphis International Airport, seen over there on that side of the screen, Diane Wingo, welcome to the show on Facebook for this morning. Taking a look at some of the delays from Memphis International, no delays being reported. That green icon means delays of 15 minutes or less, so not really seeing too much of anything out there in the way of major problems or delays at this time. So good news for travelers here in the Mid-South area. Now we are seeing lessening delays at Newark, so good news on that. Delays of 15 to 30 minutes or so. And Miami was up to about 45 minute delays. That has since improved as well, so it looks like, or looks like it's not improving, it's getting worse, unfortunately. So if you're traveling through or into Miami, you may wind up with some problems there, but much nicer in Miami. I mean, look at those temperatures right there, back about 75 degrees. It was near zero at O'Hare in Chicago early this morning, but no delays showing up there. And good travel weather across much of the United States, so good news if you are going to be heading out the door. Likewise, on Storm Tracker 3S radar, we don't have, again, a lot going on. Currently seeing dry conditions across much of the area. Did have some scattered snow showers yesterday over southeast Arkansas and northern Mississippi, but nothing like that showing up for this morning. Likewise, not a lot happening on the regional display. We've got a few scattered showers down around the Gulf Coast and some snow showers with a storm system barreling through the upper plain states. That could be a significant snowmaker for Chicago, the Great Lakes, and even into New England over the next couple of days. Reed Timmer, storm chaser, was talking about another possible foot to 2 feet of snow on the leeward side of the lakes into the next couple of days. Jay Logan, weather guy, welcome to the show on Periscope and Twitter. Thanks for stopping by. And Tim Biggers, thanks for watching the show on Facebook for this morning. Currently in the Mid-South, and when we say currently, we mean currently. This is live, real-time, as it happens weather. You'll see the display here change from time to time. Southwest winds at 3, Heidelberg Elementary in Clarksdale. 8-mile-per-hour winds now down to 1 at Clarksdale. 8-mile-per-hour winds, Memphis International, and at the airport in Tunica, Mississippi. 21 degrees at West Memphis at the airport, and those are the warmest temperatures in the Mid-South. No, I'm not kidding about that. That's where we see, again, the warmest conditions out there. But looking at some much nicer conditions where the temperatures are concerned, we'll take a look at that coming up here in just a little bit. Rest of the day today, temperatures, again, not doing too bad at first. It's going to be cold, but it's not going to be quite as cold as before. Temperatures today, I think the computer is kind of hedging its bets a little bit. It notices the computer seeing the winds coming out of the north here, but it's a very good possibility that the computer with these colder temperatures thinks that that reinforcing shot of cold air is really still in progress. The winds are going to be much lighter today, and it's also going to be a lot of sunshine out there. Now, we topped 30 degrees yesterday. I'm thinking that the temperatures for highs later on this afternoon may be a little bit higher than this, hopefully in the lower to mid-30s, and that's what you'll see on our 7 to 10-day forecast coming up here in just a little bit. So we will be kind of moderating the temperatures in just a little bit. So Michael Clark on Facebook, yes, we will get some temperatures moderated out there, but it is still going to be very cold into tomorrow morning by daybreak and around live at 9. Mid to upper areas of 20s, and that's going to be about it as we see, again, the potential for some more problems out there into and around the Mid-South. Now, extended forecast. This is where we see, again, the possibility of some more problems into the area, where we get, again, the potential for some more areas of snow showers starting to make their way into the forecast as we get into and around portions of the area into close to New Year's Eve morning. Looks like the possibility of seeing, again, some snow showers starting to make their way our direction by early around New Year's Eve day, and then that continues to spill in and fill up into and around the area of Sunday night, and that includes right around the time the ball drops in New York City and the guitar drops on Beale Street. So we could be looking at some frozen precipitation, much better chances than what we saw for before. Ignore this forecast right down there. I don't know why that's got the old data on it. I apologize. That's not the forecast for the Mid-South at this point in time. Dustin Brumfield, here's what it looks like again for frozen precip chances out there for this weekend. Again, snow chances will start as we go into around Sunday late during the day into the afternoon. Now, this map that you see here is, again, as it says right here, for the possibility of snow. Taking another computer model and running it forward, we see the possibility of maybe some type of mixture out there, leaning toward sleet at first and then towards snow. It looks like we're going to see the snow portion right on the northern edge of this mixture here, and then into northern parts of Mississippi, and then right south of there into around areas just north of Jackson. We could be looking at some form of a mixture of precipitation, rain, snow, freezing rain, sleet, grapple, which is sleet pellets that are too big for sleet but too small for hail. That's, again, a possibility out there. The potential is there, and with numbers like this on this computer model showing up this early, this definitely bears watching as a situation. So snow, a very good possibility. Less excited about the possibility of frozen and or freezing mixture, but numbers are increasing on here, and we're going to be watching again that with a lot of interest over the course of the rest of the day today and into around the rest of the forecast. Let me get rid of that forecast on there because that's starting to annoy me that something did not update on there, and I don't want people to be looking at 50s for temperatures into the rest of the weekend because that would not be what we're looking for. So what we're seeing again is going to be changeable situation into the evening hours, and then that could spread all the way down to about I-20 in Jackson, Mississippi as we go through the evening hours. For about New Year's Eve into very early New Year's morning, this could spell a lot of travel problems depending on how this situation shapes up. We will be keeping, again, a very close eye on this, so stay tuned for more. Now, again, very optimistic about this, but we should be making the mid-30s for highs today across much of the Mid-South. Extra sunshine, dry air, and less winds. That should spell some warmer temperatures. Granted, it's not exactly tropical, but we'll take what we can get at this point. Tomorrow's temperature is a little bit better, back in the lower 40s, so looking a lot better there, and also staying in the lower 40s as we head toward around Saturday or so, with temperatures back in the lower 40s. Again, that's about maybe 10, 15 degrees below normal, but better than what we've seen. Now, getting into New Year's Eve, Sunday evening, high temperatures on Sunday only in the mid-20s, moisture increasing throughout the area, more clouds possible. It doesn't look like much at this point in time. We've only thrown in about a 20% chance of anything involving frozen precip. And keep in mind that most of what this forecast is meant for is a baseline for the metro area and Shelby County. North, it's going to be colder. South, it's going to be a little warmer than what you see here. And then some of that moisture could stick around very early into New Year's Day. And we're looking at a very big burst of cold air returning to the Mid-South once again. So we are seeing that potential for some very cold air in the area with lower 20s for highs. That, excuse me, is not really what's bothering me at this point. What we're really looking at is this right here. A lot of schools and a lot of businesses are going to be going back to work on January the 2nd, and heading out to the bus stop or getting that car started on Tuesday morning is going to be possibly a problem for a lot of the Mid-South, especially for the kids. And once again, this is not going to be one of those situations where you can just turn up the winter coat and throw a ball cap on. You've really got to prepare ahead for this. If the kids are waiting out for the bus stop in weather like this, they really need to be prepared, because temperatures like this, again, frostbite is a possibility with exposed skin out there. So gloves, hats, scarves, wrap around the mufflers, everything else like that would be a very good idea to make certain you're ready for this. So again, please keep it tuned to News Channel 3 on that. Let's go further into the new year for the 10-day forecast. Again, temperatures remain in the lower 30s. Bit of a downturn on temperatures, a weak bit of cold air on Thursday, and then on Saturday we bump back up into the mid-40s, warmer than what we have seen over the last several days, and could be quite possibly the potential of maybe some area snow showers out there. It does not look like much for the time being, but that's something I think we should should watch very carefully, just in case, to keep you updated on what may be going on out there. Again, the main thing we're going to be watching is, of course, the potential for precipitation New Year's Eve into New Year's Day. Sorry, I got wires all over the place here. Kind of hard to see with all this going on. Connected at various spots. I haven't used duct tape yet, but that might be next. You never know. Now, again, for the rest of the next couple of days, temperatures will be, again, a little bit chilly, not as bad as they have been, but at least we'll be back in the mid-30s for today. And then toward New Year's, that's where we're seeing that potential of maybe some problems coming in that we really, really need to watch. And that's what we'll be doing here, so keep it tuned for more. Yofi Tofi, number one, thanks for joining us on Periscope and Twitter for this morning. Thanks to everybody for dropping on by for a check of the forecast. Weather pictures in the Mid-South. Sherry, beware, ready for wintertime from what it looks like, and she says yes, she would like to have some winter precipitation. Still haven't seen Game of Thrones yet. I'm hoping to read the books first, but nice little winter is coming graphic there thrown in quite nicely. And starting a trend of taking pictures of your thermometer on your car dashboard, registering a temperature of 24 degrees in and around the area. I believe Salisbury, Tennessee, if I'm not mistaken, at 1 p.m. yesterday, or Bolivar, I'm sorry, 24 degrees in Bolivar there. And Louis Haskett from Northeast Arkansas, a little bit more of a direct view of how he feels about winter weather, hashtag die winter. Well, that's one way to put it, I suppose, but still got about 88 days of winter to go before we get into springtime, so we've got a long ways to go on that. Thanks to everybody for sending in those pictures, but if you're going to take pictures of your dashboard, may I just briefly request that you do it while the car is sitting still. Doing stuff like this while you're in drive makes me very nervous, so please just park at some place and then take the picture. It's not necessary for me to get the picture while you're driving, just for effect, so just let's be safe out there and just make certain that we're doing things the right way into and around that area. Michael Clark, GOT Books, cheap on Kindle. Let's see, and sit somewhere in silence, a lot to take in. That's cool. I could use some more stuff to read in the new year. That's actually one of my New Year's resolutions, taking more pictures for our weather department and then also doing a lot more reading. That's maybe I'll have to add like a what I'm reading here bar and how far I'm up to on this. But thank you very much for the suggestion on that. I'll definitely be taking that into consideration. Questions or comments, anything like that, you can contact me on any of these social media networks that you see above my head or in the graphic over there. If you've got pictures, we want to see them so we can show them on netcast like this, but we can't show them if you don't send them. So you kind of see the problem there. So if you'd like to drop your pictures off, send them to me, tweet them to me at aonic_WREG3 on my main Facebook page or on my Instagram page at aonic_WREG3, and we'd love to show them around to everybody. So please drop them on by and keep us updated on that. Join me for a year-ending forecast on AM 730 with Bob and Josh tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Monday through Friday throughout the rest of the year. And if you can't listen because you're out of range from Memphis of the AM 730 signal, all you have to do is dial up talkbacklivenetwork.org and you'll be able to learn a lot more about the forecast. Bob and Josh have on some great guests. They mainly talk sports, but they also talk a lot of community events, some news thrown in there as well. Great way to get your day started. Callers with information, great opportunity to listen in on what's going on there. AM 730, 8 to 10 a.m. Monday through Friday. And, of course, Jim Jaggers will have more on your complete into the new year forecast starting on 1st at 4 today and going right on in through about News Channel 3 at 10. And, of course, I'll be back on with News Channel 3 Daybreak into tomorrow morning. That'll do it for this edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. We're going to continue to monitor that potential for winter weather heading our way into the new year. So keep it tuned in more with News Channel 3 on that. Again, questions, concerns, ideas, comments, anything that you would like to know about, my email address in the blue bar up on the top portion right there on the phone thingy, austin.onek@wreg.com. And would love to have you along for the ride on that. I'll be on News Channel 3 at noon for an update of the forecast there. Nina Harrelson will have more on the newscast situation. And again, Jim Jaggers, more details on your forecast coming up later on tonight. Thanks for joining us for today's edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime, at just before 11 o'clock on Thursday morning. And more to come with News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the day. Thanks for joining us.